this is where I started. I started on the right side of it, so this one was already done about a week ago. And I've been transplanting local onions that I'm finding and some local plants that I wanted to move out of some garden boxes. So I wanted to get these into the mounds just to get some roots going and get some soil building and, you know, just get some growth started in there. So the back I don't have any access to on my bed, so I had to design it this way where I have a little path over here, and then I've been sheet mulching the paths on the outside of the box, and then I'm going to be arching these Hugelkultur mounds all the way around, and then this path is just mulch, about a foot deep or so. And then the Hugelkultur mounds are about 18 inches that I dug down. I dug down until I found some roots from a nearby tree. And so I just pulled those out, and not all of them, of course, but what I could get at. And I didn't really dig down too much deeper than that. So I can show you. So this was the left side that I worked on today. And I've been slowly bringing in pieces of wood, large firewood for the lower chunks. I didn't really have time to get pictures as I was going along. I was just kind of working fast because I was in a time crunch. So, but I had some mulch from the mulch piles, found some good broken down black stuff from the lower parts of the mulch piles. So I threw that in there and layered in some leaves and some dried out weeds from the plot that was here originally, and I laid them out and let them dry for 4 or 5 days before I throw them in there, let the roots die and dry out. So yeah, can't really tell, but yeah, I dug this trench a few days ago and today, and I finished out that trench, and then just kind of went for it with the layering really quickly. Ran over to the mulch pile a few times, and so this is kind of what I got done today, and you can kind of see it starting to take shape. So this is the left side, this is my, you know, this is my path, and it's going to connect in with the other side there along the back, so my next job is to probably do that path, and it's coming along. I like all the mulch that I'm using. We're in a very severe drought. I looked it up, and in 2019, my town had 18 inches of rain for the whole, for all of 2019, so it's pretty ridiculous, kind of the rainfall, and that's been pretty, and that was actually kind of heavy for, compared to the past 7, 8 years before that. So, that's why I'm using a lot of mulch, and I'm kind of connecting it underneath. I'm kind of connecting the mulch to the mulch layer that's on the path on the outside of the box too, so it's all going to be one system that's kind of able to hold a lot of water. And that's why I'm doing a Hugelkultur too, just for water holding purposes, and because it, you know, just takes up a lot of green waste that would otherwise get thrown away or sent out. And I really enjoy this style just because turns spongy, it provides nutrients. I mean, this thing's going to provide nutrients for a long time, probably for 15 years or so. And it's just a really good basis. It's worth the work for starting it out, because it's pretty labor intensive digging down, and then I'm like pulling out all the weeds and sorting them and sorting the spiky plants out so I can sheet mulch over those. And so it's labor intensive, but it's really fun. I really enjoy it, and I think it's going to be very productive. I also threw some seeds down as I go, as I finish a section. So some firewood was the first layer underneath, and then leaves. I gathered up some leaves and a little bit of mulch, and I was always layering it with the soil just to have a little bit of the microbes from the soil at every layer of that too. So that was my work for today, and watered it. shovel and my seeds, and that's it. So, all right, hope you got something out of that, and go take action and start your own.